young contestants and their host, Jim MacKrell.
Thank you, Mike. Thank you, thank you. Nice to see you. We welcome you to the Quiz Kids, the show with a brand new generation of wit and wisdom. I'd like you to meet them right now. Finally made it to the bottom rung. Huh, David?
Yep, I sure did. My name's David Nacht. I'm from Lexington, Massachusetts, and I finally got down here.
Terrific. Irene?
My name's Irene Hurley. I go to 7th grade in Longfellow in Cambridge, Massachusetts.
Very good, Irene. And Joel, nice to see you, sir.
My name's Joel Hirschhorn. I'm 14 years old, and I'm in the 10th grade at Stuyvesant High School.
Good for you. Where is that, sir?
In New York City.
In New York City. All right. And those are our champions on the Quiz Kids. We have two challengers. We'll start off with you, Andrea. How are you?
Fine.
Good.
My name is Andrew Bertozzi. I come from Lexington, Massachusetts. Diamond Junior High School. I'm in the 9th grade and I'm 14 years old.
Good for you, Andrea. Welcome to the Quiz Kids. And say hello, John.
Hello, I'm yet another person from Lexington, and I'm 14 years old. My name is John Kurtz, and I hope to continue Lexington's winning tradition on the Quiz Kids.
Good for you, John. That's terrific. Welcome you both. You know how to play our game. We'll play four rounds. Each of you start with 200 points. Get ready with your fingers on your buzzers, because I'll read the questions, you buzz in. First one to buzz in gets to answer the question. If you're right, we give you 20 points. If you're incorrect, we take the 20 away from your existing score. We wish you good luck. All set?
Yep.
Two reporters uncovered one of the most explosive political scandals of this century, the Nixon Watergate cover-ups. Name the reporters.
Woodward, David. And Bernstein.
Right you are. Mathematics question. Grab pencils and paper. You may want to write this down. If we multiply the bracket A plus B by the bracket A minus B, what answer do we obtain? Andrea.
A squared minus B squared.
Right you are. Very good answer. The modern British playwright Tom Stoppard created a play in the 1960s in which two minor characters from Shakespeare's Hamlet are the title characters. What are the characters' names? Anyone? Rosencrantz and Guildenstern. The play was called Are Dead. Both of them are dead. Here we go. If a 16th note is called a semiquaver, what is a 32nd note called? Joel?
Hemisemiquaver?
No. I'm sorry, you're really close, though. Anyone for 10 points? Yes, John?
A full quaver?
A full quaver? No, sir. We keep quaving around. We're going to get this, aren't we? 32nd note is called a demi-semi-quaver. And you gave us almost a 64th note. That's a hemi-demi-semi-quaver. After serving two terms and retiring, Teddy Roosevelt ran as a candidate for the Progressive Party. What is the famous nickname for this party? Anyone? It's the Bull Moose Party. Let the day perish wherein I was born. Now, these are the words of a man in the Bible who endured great suffering, but never... Irene?
Job.
Job is correct. Never lost his faith in God. The Romans built a defensive barrier to protect Britain from the northern raiders. It's completed in...
Hadrian's Wall.
Right you are, David. Again, let me caution you, when you buzz in, wait for me to call, because we want the camera to get on you so your pretty smile will show up all over America.
Sorry.
Here we go. Math question, pencil and paper, please. A teenage boy is 5 times older than his brother is now. In 3 years, he will be only 3 times old as his brother is then. How old will the brothers be in 3 years? Joel.
18 and 6.
Yes, sir. Very good. Did you figure that out, or, I mean, did you use the paper, or was it here?
No, it was there.
Jacob Robert Oppenheimer was the physicist in charge of the Manhattan Project. What was the Manhattan Project, David?
It was to develop the A-bomb for the United States during World War II.
Congratulations. Very well done, David. All right, that gives you the lead, David. You have 260. John is in fifth place. This controversial American general led U.S. troops to victories in Tunisia and France, known as Old Blood and Guts. David?
General George Patton.
Right!
Yes, sir.
Michelangelo is famous for the painting of the Sistine Chapel.
What is the title of the east wall of the...
The Judgment, Judgment Day. The Last Judgment Day,
the Last Judgment, correct. In 1877, 2 years after he discovered the site of ancient Troy, Heinrich Schliemann unearthed the remains of another important city of the ancient world. What was it?
Pompeii?
Pompeii, no. Mycenae. Mm. All right. Hands on buzzers. The surface of the planet Saturn is hidden behind a dense atmosphere. Two main gases have been detected and are presently believed to form part of Saturn's atmosphere. Can you name at least one of them? Joel?
Methane.
Methane, and do you know the other?
Is it ammonia?
No, it's hydrogen, but we asked for methane. We'll recap the scores. David is in the lead with 260, Irene has 240, Joel 220, John 190, Andrea 220, and we have this timeout, and we'll be right back with the second round.
If you'd like to become a Quiz Kid, write to Quiz Kids, Box 8486, Boston, Massachusetts, 02114. Now, with the second round of the Quiz Kids, here's our host, Jim MacKrell.
Thank you very much. David has the lead with 260 points. The second round really proved to be exciting. It's played exactly like the first. Hands on buzzers. Here we go. Agatha Christie created two of the most famous detectives in fiction. One was an English spinster, the other a little Belgium gentleman. Can you name them? Joel.
The Belgian was Hercule Poirot. And the spinster was Miss Jane Marple.
Right. Good for you. Very well done, Joel. One of Shakespeare's title characters described his wife as being too full of the milk of human kindness. Give me either the name of the man or his wife. One of Shakespeare's characters said his wife was too full of the milk of human kindness. All right, it was Macbeth describing Lady Macbeth. Moving on. Name the first Republican candidate to become President of the United States. The first Republican candidate.
Republican meaning the full name of...
The Republican
there was
meaning...
was a Democratic Republican Party. That's what it was called. It was one party. Do you mean that?
I mean the Republican Party. As in the Republican Party.
As in the Republican Party?
Yes, sir. I need an answer from someone, please. Oh, you're going to get angry at yourself. First Republican in 1860 was Abraham Lincoln.
Democratic Republican.
American involvement in Vietnam began in 1954 and lasted through the terms of office of five presidents. Can you name them? David.
Okay, I'm going to go backwards and stop when I get to five.
Thanks a lot, David.
Okay, sure. We have Nixon, Johnson, Kennedy, Eisenhower. Let me see who I'm missing here. Kennedy, Eisenhower, Nixon, Johnson. Hold on a second. Eisenhower, Kennedy, Johnson, Nixon, Ford.
Uh-huh. That's right. Got them all. Good. I couldn't tell where we were going backwards and forwards.
I didn't even know Ford was in there, but I figured who else could it be?
That says a lot about him. The three novels, The Wizard of Earthsea, The Tombs of Atuan, and The Father's Shore, though published separately, have become known as the Earthsea Trilogy. Who is the author? Joel.
Ursula K. Le Guin.
Right, Joel. Math calculation. What is the... everyone ready? What is the answer expressed as a percentage obtained when you divide 4.72 by 47.2. Joel?
10%.
10% is correct. Joel, I could use you to help me compute tips at a restaurant. During the Spanish-American War of 1898, American naval and marine forces were used to enforce the annexation of a four-year-old republic. What was the republic?
Could you repeat that again, please?
During the Spanish-American War of 1898, American naval and marine forces were used to enforce the annexation of a four-year-old republic. John.
Philippines?
Philippines is incorrect for 10 points.
Cuba?
I'm sorry, you must buzz in, David. Go ahead.
Cuba?
Is incorrect. I'm sorry, it was Hawaii. Math question again. If three hens lay a combined total of three eggs in 3 days,
How many hens will lay 100 eggs in 100 days?
Could you go over that one more?
Yes, I will. If three hens lay a combined total of 3 eggs in 3 days, how many hens will lay 100 eggs in 100 days? Joel?
Three
hens. Busy. Very good. Okay. An American admiral earned the nickname Bull, supposedly because of his violent temper. He was the commander of the naval forces.
Halsey.
David?
Sorry. Halsey.
Halsey is right. Admiral William Halsey. Good. Name of the Roman goddess of flowering or blossoming plants.
Flora.
Irene?
Flora.
Flora is correct. The segregation laws passed in the southern states after the Civil War from 1870 to 1950 were commonly described by the name of a character in a black minstrel show. What was the name of the laws?
Could you
repeat that? Yes, I will. The segregation laws passed in the southern states after the Civil War from the 1870s to the 1950s were commonly described by the name of a character in a black minstrel show. What were these laws, or what was the character? You do not know? It was the Jim Crow laws. Here's our last question. Devolution is a term that may sound like man is going back to the apes, but in Scotland and Wales recently, it has a different meaning. What does the term devolution refer? Anyone? It refers to home rule, independent governments in those countries. Our home rule. All right, let's quickly check our score. Joel has the lead with 300. David is in second place with 270. Irene has 260. We'll be back, and the whole thing can change just like that right after this.